When I first moved to Wuhan in 2018, nobody back home knew where it was. Now, unfortunately, it will always be remembered.
After the test, they have to do this, keep the vertical. Keep the vertical.
On the 22nd of January 2020, I boarded a train with my partner to go and visit his hometown in a much smaller city in the next province. Little was I to know that the next day, 10 a.m, Wuhan would close its doors and I wouldn't see it again for over 100 days. A few weeks ago, I returned to the city that I now feel is home, a second home. Last night we went to a big family meal, big round table, spinning table with dishes on it so people can help themselves. We had little speeches. Bruce's mom stood up at one point and said, "Dion, like, welcome to our family and we love you," and like, oh, I just find that so nice. Like, I genuinely love them too, and it's like, it's bizarre, like, I never thought that I could say I love you about people that I can't communicate with, but I genuinely, honestly do. The last goodbye to the room. Bye-bye house. Do you remember the last time we were here?
Last time? We're in train station now. We found that there's no worker in the ticket room. Means Dion can't leave the city. Yeah.
The government need know your
location.
Yeah,
the government needs to know where all the foreigners are. Here we go. How's the... Oh, it's quite clean. I think I cleaned before I left. Let's see. Okay.
What?
It's not that bad. Here's the real demon. The fridge. Okay. Everything on the... Oh! No, it's the other side. It's that side. Oh, ready? Go. Okay, so... It's the first proper day in Wuhan now. We're gonna go meet some friends, have a picnic. Let's go meet Phil. Stop looking at someone's car.
Put my ass on,
so you have to scan the QR to make sure you're happy. So you scan it. Car's number, so it tracks wherever you go. If you don't have a green QR code, you can't scan it.
Hello! Oh my god!
Me too. How long has it been? It's only been a week.
It's been 3 fucking months.
It was only supposed to be a week.
I know, it was only supposed to be 1 week. So you have to scan the QR code with your health certificate, and then he'll check your temperature. You show him that you've got the QR code certificate and then you can get in. But Phil can't get in because his isn't working. Phil's scanning it. Click enter. Checks your temperature. And then you can get in. summer.
Bye, mate.
Yeah, we missed you too, mate.
Right, so we've just been to East Lake and now we're going to Huaiandao.
What
are you drank for? I had a few tinnies, like.
How many?
How many? Four tinnies.
Huaiandao.
Exactly.
Yeah. Oh, hello. What, is this a video?
Yeah.
Okay.
Hilda, how long were you in quarantine for?
90 freaking days of my life.
Hey.
How was it?
All I can say is I'm a survivor.
Phil, what was your experience of lockdown?
Fucking mental. Nah, it was alright to be honest. Pretty chilled. Like, everyone was making it out to be like insane on the streets, but it actually wasn't. It was alright.
How long did you spend in Wuhan before you got evacuated?
17 days.
And then how long were you in England?
1 month.
And then how long have you been back in China?
So I arrived in China on the 10th of March. I had to spend 7 weeks in Shanghai.
Yeah.
And then arrived back in Wuhan on last Thursday.
Are you happy to be back?
Oh man, it just feels like coming home.
So Hilda, you were in Wuhan the whole time, right? So you never left.
I am the ultimate survivor.
Yeah.
I did.
You never left.
I feel like, you know, those TV shows, like Survivor. I was in Wuhan for freaking 90 days before I could actually leave my house. It was a good 90 days.
So how did you feel when the lockdown first happened? How long did you think it was going to last?
Well, I think it was a shock to the system because all we thought was there's a flu going around. And before we knew it, the airports were closed and we couldn't go anywhere. I cancelled my vacation and I became a very good chef and a baker and I did my own nails. So this is my lockdown story.
How does it feel to be outside now?
It's amazing, it's surreal.
Where are we going, Phil?
Going to Bounty, mate.
For what?
A bit of rum, mate.